Okay, so we are going to discuss another theorem in this session. So this theorem is a triangle is divided by its medians into six smaller triangles of equal area. So hence we know what a median is. So median is a CVN, which divides, or rather which bisects the opposite side, right? Opposite side, that is a dash in this figure is a median. Similarly, BB dash and CC dash are median. So they bisect the side BC, CA, AB respectively. Okay, so we have to prove that there all the three medians, if you can see, there are six parts of this triangle, you know, formed by the medians. So let me name them first. So let us say this side, this triangle is alpha, and this is beta, gamma, delta, epsilon, and let's say sigma. Okay, so I am just labeling all these six areas. Now guys, if you see, alpha is equal to beta. Why? Because it is nothing but area of triangle GBA dash is equal to area of triangle GA dash C. Why? Because equal base, both of them have equal base. What base? BA dash is equal to A dash C, because AA dash is a median, and same height. Why same height? Because both of them have the common vertex G. Okay, so alpha is equal to beta. Similarly, so this is one, let's say. Similarly, you can say gamma is equal to delta. Gamma is equal to delta. And let's say this one is 2, and epsilon is equal to sigma. Okay, this is, let's say, 3. Okay, also area of triangle ABA dash is equal to area of triangle AA dash C. Why? Again, equal base, and that is BA dash is equal to A dash C, and same height, right? So this means, what do we get? We get alpha plus sigma plus epsilon is equal to beta plus gamma plus delta. Now, if you see, alpha is equal to beta, so I can strike off alpha and beta. And sigma plus epsilon, so sigma is epsilon, so I can write 2 sigma is equal to 2 gamma. 2 sigma is equal to 2 gamma, or 2 sigma is equal to 2 gamma. I can say 2 gamma. Why? Because gamma is equal to delta from here, 2, and epsilon is equal to sigma. This means sigma is equal to gamma. Sigma is equal to gamma. Similarly, you can prove that alpha is equal to sigma. You can do that as well, right? Why? Because if you can you write these two, this thing, what? That sigma plus delta plus gamma will be equal to epsilon plus gamma plus delta is sigma plus alpha plus beta, right? Same reason. Now in this, alpha and sigma are same. Okay, so hence, and gamma and delta. So gamma and delta are also same. So you can write 2 gamma is equal to 2 alpha. So hence, from here you get alpha is equal to delta as well. So hence, instead of sigma, you can write alpha is equal to delta. But it hardly, you know, matters. Why? Because now you know that sigma is equal to gamma and alpha is equal to delta. So hence, all of them are actually equal. So if you see, alpha is equal to gamma and gamma was equal to alpha is equal to delta and delta is equal to gamma. So hence, if you see carefully, all becomes equal. Alpha was equal to beta, and alpha was equal to delta, so I can write alpha is equal to delta, and delta was equal to gamma, so I can write delta is equal to gamma, correct? And gamma was equal to sigma, so I can write sigma, and sigma was equal to epsilon, so all are equal. All are equal, right? So hence, what do we conclude? So the three medians together divide the triangle into equal areas, six parts of equal area, isn't it? Now the same logic can be used to establish that the medians divide the two triangles, divides themselves into 2:1 ratio. That we will prove in the next session.